Hi, my name is Weston McCammon, and I'm the facilitator for this online class, Biology. And I just wanted to kind of go over some things with you about the class. First of all, under Faculty Information, you're going to see my contact information. Tuesday nights I'm going to be out, so I'm going to need to change this. So not Tuesdays, but usually on Thursdays from 6 to 9, I'll be at home and ready to take your phone calls if you need me. This is my cell phone number. Feel free to use it if you need to. Of course, I'm not in room 15. There is no room 15. I'll be at home, of course, during that time. So let's start by looking at the course. This is what you're going to see when you log in, and when you go to the class, you're going to see this. Notice the countdown here, time and how much time we've got left to get your assignments done before the end of the course. So let's start off with how to work the course. Over here on the side, you've got the Assignment Center. That's where you're going to find your assignments for the week. Module 1, Chapter 25, due January the 24th, 2010, I guess is how you're going to say it, by 3 p.m. That is a firm deadline. This little link right here will disappear at 3 p.m. That means no assignments can be turned in after 3 p.m. on January the 24th. If you can't make it by that time, perhaps you need to consider changing the course, because I need them in by 3 p.m. so I can have them graded and have your grades updated. Okay? So, I'm going to click on this assignments to begin this week's assignments. Right there, it's going to pull up this first page, which is your main, like, content. Now, if you wanted to see all the assignments, this says page 1 of 8. That means there are 8 assignments, or 8 things, in this chapter. And you can see those 8 things by clicking content. Just you can have a list. You may want to print this and check it off as you do it. All right, so first of all, we're going to start with terms of anatomy, types of tissues in the integumentary system. It's going to start with chapter 25. All right, so on this page, I give you kind of a list of things to do. And first of all, you need to complete the student information sheet by clicking here. It's going to take you to an external website where you'll do those. Then, of course, we have some introductory paperwork that I need you to fill in for me. Course syllabus, of course, you don't have to turn that in. But these 4 things, I want you to type your name as your digital signature and submit those back to me. And you'll see these in the gradebook as complete or incomplete. Pacing guide, additional course requirements, safety guide, and the netiquette. Pacing guide just gives you the how we're going to be doing things, the sequence. Additional course requirements are some additional things in addition to the course syllabus that I want to emphasize. The safety guide, so you can be safe at home when you're doing labs and things. And the netiquette, so you'll know how to behave in the discussion forums and in general with people on the internet. So if you'll just type those, and you're going to submit those things to me as your first 3 assignments. Next, you've got your notes and review questions. So if you wanted to check out the notes for this chapter, just click right there, and it's going to pull up a window. And here is, of course, the notes that go along with chapter 25 in your textbook. And you can follow along those as you're reading to kind of help you emphasize what to study. And of course, down below that are a set of review questions to practice, to help yourself out with. All right, the next thing you have to do is the Chapter 25 work file. You're going to click this, and it's going to download to your computer. It's going to say Chapter 25. You're going to fill this in. It's going to look kind of like this. You're going to type your answers to these questions in these blanks, and you're going to submit it back to me. Now, when you get all this typed in, you're going to do like you always do, file and save as, and save it to your computer. Okay, and then back here, you're going to see some things that I strongly suggest you do before the test to help you review. Some of these are games. Some of these are little quizzes that you just do for yourself. These two are really good, about the body regions. And then you've got a little practice test before you take the real test, and then, of course, it tells you your last 2 things. So it's kind of like a little index of what you need to do for the test. Okay, so let's go on to the next thing. I'm going to click this little next arrow here to go to the next assignment. This is the pacing guide upload. You're going to click right here, and it's going to let you update the pace, and then I can go to the next page. This is the additional course requirements upload. the safety guide upload, the netiquette upload, and then the chapter 25 upload. So this is where you're going to put chapter 25 work file. So let's look at how you would do that as an example on how you do all of them. So once you get the chapter 25 assignment done, you're going to click here under View Complete Assignments, and you're going to scroll down to Choose File. And you're just going to click Choose File. Alright, it's going to pull up your desktop, and I'm going to search for that chapter 25 work file that I typed in. There it is. And it's listed right there. Now you've got two buttons down here, Save or Submit. If you click Save, you can come back later and edit it. But what we want to do is click Submit. Submit sends it to me for grading. That's what you want to do. I want to be able to see it to be able to grade it. So click Submit, not Save, unless you're going to come back and work on it later. But Submit. Okay. Once you do that, you're done with this assignment. And you can move on to the next thing, which is the chapter test, chapter 25 test. And you're just going to click right there to launch the chapter 25 test. And it's just a series of questions you're going to need to answer. And then once you're through your test, you can come back and do your last assignment for this module. And that is the forum. And it's going to ask you some questions to write in your forum. Your forum is kind of like your discussion board, where you and your classmates need to get together and discuss certain aspects of this. So you've got to find a disease of your choice and describe some first, second, and third degree burns. Remember, to get full credit, you'll have to make one original post and respond to your classmates. Something else besides good job, nice post. Be creative. Criticize them. If they got it wrong, tell them they got it wrong. If they got it right, let them know what you enjoyed about reading their post. Alright, of course once you're done with this, you're done with this module up until the next week. Course runs from Sunday to Sunday. Sunday at 3 o'clock is when I start grading, because Sunday at 3 o'clock all the assignments close down. And so the next week's assignments will be posted on Sunday, probably Sunday morning. So if you have any questions, feel free to give me a call. One last thing. If you don't log into the class in 2 weeks, that's 14 days. When I go look, in 14 days you have not been in class. I'm going to submit a drop slip for you and you'll be removed from class. That's one way you can be removed from class. The other way you can be removed from class is for cheating. Because this is an online program, I take cheating very, very seriously. If you're caught cheating, if your work file looks identical to someone else's work file, if your answers are identical, you will receive a drop from the class immediately, and I'm going to do my very best to get you dropped with an F. Do not cheat in this class. This is your one and only warning. Do not cheat. Cheating will get you either withdrawn and possibly removed from school. Cheating is taken very seriously by the colleges. Do not cheat. Okay? Last word of warning. Other than that, I hope we have a great time together. Alright? Hope you enjoyed the video. Have a great day.